Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and we're heading to, I think it's Sansrie's Island, in the village of Snakesign, and Sansrie's temple or whatever. I think it's this one? On the Windgate Island? No, it's not that one. I know it's one of the right most ones. So we went through third row, fourth row? Nope. I didn't think it was this one. Nope. Did I? Second row? Is this it? You know, this is not it. Last row? I went through that by mistake. Alright, rest, because I can't see. This is the last row. Is this it? Yes, yes. Ouch, ouch. No. Something tells me I keep going through the same one over and over again. Instead of going to a new one. I thought it was a right gate. Let's try the left ones. Is this it? I don't think so. Maybe. No. Not it. There's a path nearby. Alright, second row. Left. Nope. Third row. Left. Ah! This is it. Okay. That's a dungeon. Trying to read this. Runes faded by the weather are still visible on the signpost. Okay. Now these are obviously directions. Probably north. West and south, I guess. We'll figure it out. Where's my runes? Okay. Y kind of character. It's been a while since I've done this. I haven't come across it in a while in the game. I did not miss it. Okay, so it's gotta be north. N-O. Yeah. Ending in H. Okay, so north. Snake sign, I'm guessing. S-N-A-K-E. Yeah, I'm not even gonna translate at all. ends in N snake sign to the north. Which you knew that. I got a map of it. Okay, so then east. Ah. East. Rest. Windgate, I'm guessing. W. Windgate. Okay. And then, what is it, south? It's not really south. Oh, U. Yeah. TH. S. A. Sansrie's. Right, and then E, apostrophe, S. I'm guessing temple? Yeah, T, E. I mean, who still talks like this? None of these people don't talk like this. Sansrie's temple, which is not really to the south. It's right here, but you have to go south to get in to the, what do you call it? Entrance of it. So if you wonder what I'm looking at with the map, it's here. We're, like, right here. Here's the temple. Yeah, I guess south along the road they mean. So then, there's the windgate. We go across this bridge, and then north, bunch of farms and stuff, and here's Snakesign, the village. So we're gonna go to Snakesign first. And what's interesting is that besides the dungeon here, there's a dungeon here, or cave, or whatever, here. And then there's something here. So I'm guessing this goes out here. In case you don't figure out the wind gates, you can get in that way. Guessing, anyway. So let's head to Snakesign. Well, these people are, like, victimized by Sansrie as they always were, I'm supposing. Not even flying my broom. You can see the following runes on the signpost. Okay, it's gonna be north. Yeah, north snake sign, south Sansrie's temple. I understand. I'm gonna camp outside the gates because I want to see everything. It's daylight out. Kind of running low on stuff here. Let's create some food. Gotta move Nelvin's food over. Killing them over here. Let's move everyone's food over. Unlike in some games, this food is permanent. But I thought I gave her that. She can't take it? Well, Edgel will hold it, I suppose. Shouldn't be overweight anymore. Alright, so we still have 16 rations here. Yay! Snakesign! City gates. Interesting. Alright, let's see what's dead ahead, I guess. On the sign, you can read Inn of the Goddess. Indeed. Greetings! Our sojourn has been long and wearisome. You do not have a description to you. A priest talks with you and says, "It is a great pity that a large part of Sansrie's temple was destroyed during the terrible floods almost 100 years ago. Even today, the lower floor of the temple is still half underwater." We're gonna need swimming skill, aren't we? Tell me you guys train in swimming? Otherwise we have to return to, I think, Burnville? Or maybe New Lake. Books. No sleeping. Time for reading. Okay, maybe not. How expensive is it? 180 gold. You don't need to rest right now. Greetings. The landlord says, "Welcome to my modest tavern. Do you perhaps need a room for the night? I have a few rooms available. Just for the tremendously low price of just 30 pieces of gold per person." No, not this time. Thank you, though. It's a little pricey, actually. Not that we don't have the money. Although most of our money is in our home. Back at home. I think we're gonna train up in swimming before we go into that dungeon. Seems like a good idea. We have a lot of training points and we have a lot of gold. So might as well spend both. An old man looks at you with curiosity in his eyes and then says, "Ah, strangers on Sansrie's island. Let us hope that our heads do not fall under the axes of Sansrie's minotaurs. Ha ha ha." Okay. Because I arrived on the island, your head will fall under the... off due to minotaurs chopping it? I'm not sure I understand the reasoning there. Or lack thereof. Well, there's nothing much going on. Is this the same guy we just talked to? Oh, that's the landlord, yeah. And I just talked to you, I just want to make sure I don't miss anybody. Priest, yes. On the door to the south hangs a large sign, "Rooms to let, please register at reception." Yeah, where was the sign? Well, I end up looking at that accidentally. Alright. Never mind. Let's see what else is in this town. what doth it say? Citrine reads on the brass sign, the wise man of snake sign. You need knowledge? I sell it. Open from 12 midday to 4 p.m. You sell knowledge. Well, we don't really need his services. Just pop in here. Nope. Okay. Looking all around here. Ah! I spot someone over there. Nothing over here, right? We can continue that way. Let's see who's skulking about in the alleyway here. Greetings! The young man is apparently very keen on talking to you. He talks about this and that, and then he says, my grandmother told me that Sansrie had winged snakes as guards in her temple before the Great Flood. He is indeed correct. See Amberstar. But they were apparently all killed by the Flood, so a few years ago she got new guards. I saw one of her guards in the temple a few days ago when I had enough money to buy a stone of Sansrie. A huge minotaur it was, half man and half bull. Its huge horns alone frightened me, quite apart from its enormous axe. Wow. Alright. Thanks for the heads up. We're gonna be fighting minotaurs. Alright. Turn to this point, what's the sign say? On the bronze plate is written, all kinds of products, open from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. Alright, so we got some kind of general store here. Incredible bargains. Lightning boots, ooh, serpent stone. Topaz, a youth potion, 5,000. Spell points 5, healing potion 4, lantern, lockpicks. Well, he's got a lot of space in which to sell things. I don't think there's anything we need to sell at this time, though. You know when they're gonna need the topaz for something. That's an earthstone. We have that here as well. I assume they stack. Yeah, they do. I mean, other than having two holy horns, which you never use, but nothing we'll really need to sell to him. And as far as what to buy from him, well, I'm assuming we're gonna need a serpent stone for something. That seems obvious. And, I would buy up all the lockpicks. And, the topaz. At the very least. But we'll actually be back. I want to see if we can spend our training points here for swimming. Oh. Hello there. Greetings. The beggar is very talkative. Amongst other things, he tells you. Well, these people like to talk. The Temple of Sansrie is basically open to everyone, at least to those who carry the Stone of Sansrie with them. But I warn you, look at me. I have become an old man because I visited the temple too often. For each time you leave the temple, the Stone of Sansrie falls to dust, and you must buy a new one from the dealer here in Snakesign. This old shark has become a very rich man, and I would bet anyone that he is sharing his profits with the priests of Sansrie. Alright. So that's what the Serpent Stone is for. It's 2,500 gold. If I saw that right, every time we go in there, I'm gonna buy one. Thanks for the heads up. Alright, what's this place? Engraved in the golden sign are the letters Healer of Sansrie. Surgery from 1 a.m. to 6 a.m. Well, they're closed. Surgery, though. And why those hours, really? The door is locked. A passerby in a hurry says, "Just your bad luck. They're closed at the moment. You should try again later." Oh, tell me what I should do. I'm guessing the sign is the same. Healers. Yeah. Anything around this side of the building? Yes, indeed. The sign shows the picture of a sack of corn, and below it the words "Food, Proprietor E. Schlagenfrass." Open from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Schlagenfrass. I see. It's very Schlagenfrassy of you. I'm guessing this also says that. Yeah. Clicking. Thank you. Good day, Mr. Schlagenfrosch. Tasty food? No, I can make my own now. We're warping inside the building. I'm assuming that's the same guy we just talked to. But I'll... Oh no! Not the same person. The bandit says, "I hope there will be no war with the elves of Ilion. I heard that Sansrie visited them and made them very angry." So you're a bandit, but you don't want to attack. Okay. Kind of disappointed. On the iron sign, you could read "Blacksmith of Snakesign. We repair everything. Open from 5 a.m. to 8 p.m. We don't need anything repaired. I need to complete the map. So we'll walk around bumping into walls. It's an interesting pillar. Building, or try to. Just trying to map it out so it looks nice and complete on the map. Find any trainers. We got a healer, a merchant, foodstuffs, blacksmith, tavern. nobody interesting inside either. And the sage. Let's go back to the merchant and buy this topaz. I think it was. I'm sure we're gonna need it for something. He said something about turning him into an old man. So I wonder if we're gonna need this youth potion. We should come back with like a lot of money. 5,000 for this. And maybe 5,000 for the serpent stone as well. So 10,000 gold. Maybe we should bring in a little extra for some healing potions. I think anyone can wear these lightning boots as well. Just about everyone. Plus 4. Yeah, we can all wear it. Plus 4. Leather boots. To give him the lightning boots as well. To get your speed up plus 25. She's got swift shoes. She's better off with the lightning boots as well. Can she use them? Just make sure. Thief, yeah. How many lightning boots is he selling? Because now I want 2 pairs. Even a mage can use it. So we want 3 pairs. She's got 1. Golden shoes. Plus 5 shield, a little better. And he's got speed on his as well. So his is better shield. We got plus 1 extra shield on it. So, so Sabine's got it. So we need for Nelvin, Selena, and Edgel. So I want 3 pairs of lightning boots. Oh, it looks like he only has 1 pair, though. Okay. So wait a second. I want to come here with how much money? I want to come here with 5,000 here. And then I wanted something else. Oh, this, a youth potion, just in case. In case it hits our healer, so 10,000. And I want the lightning boots. 'Cause lockpicks I'll just buy now, in case. Oh, we're okay. Never mind. Plus 75. Okay, so I'm doing math. Don't bother me. So I'm gonna come back with like 11,875 or so. I'll buy up the rest with healing potions. I think I'll give the lightning boots to Nelvin. He needs the better AC as he can, best AC as he can get since he has low hit points. Alright, since we're broke, we gotta come back. I can't pass through it with that, no. Alright, back to the Windgate Island. Off screen, I will collect this money. Probably gonna collect some money and then actually train up in swimming. I'll show you guys that. That's probably gonna be in Burnville. I think it's in Burnville. A hard time remembering. But we can take a Windgate there. Figure out which Windgate to go to. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.